Meet Sidhant. He's a grade A academic and a spelling bee super champ. Yeah! Who'd rather work his brain than work his muscles.
Come on, baby. Okay, stop.
Now this scrawny speller,
she's so strong,
wants to swap his studies for gridiron glory. By being made into a football quarterback.
Oh man.
MTV will pair him up with a former NFL superstar.
I feel good, that's football.
Who will mold this king of the classroom into a touchdown titan. But is 9 weeks enough time for Sid to master the game?
You do throw like crap.
Will Sid bulk up for the big scrimmage?
Focus! Pull!
Or will he dodge his duties?
How can we run football?
Can Sid lead his team to glory, or will it be lights out on his dream?
Can't do it anymore.
Find out next on MADE.
All this will be yours. Top of the world, man.
So it was off to football university, all the way in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania, where I'd be schooled by the best of the best.
All right, sit down, have fun.
Hooray. Welcome to football university. As a quarterback, one of your biggest responsibilities is leadership. Leadership comes from being the hardest worker on a team.
What you're gonna do is just play catch with each other.
Roland wasn't kidding. These guys were great. I was definitely a fish out of water. That's Andre Rison. He's a Super Bowl champion and a veteran instructor at football university.
Well, can you come throw some balls over here?
Sure.
Come on.
1, 2, 3,
I was glad my first day on the field was over, but I was nervous about what would be in store for the next day.
Sid, what's happening? It's early in the morning,
yeah.
But we gotta get better. Brought you some cleats from FBU and from myself. You know, wear them with pride. Can't be throwing like Cindy, can't be throwing like Mindy. Okay. All right, let's go.
Hopefully the new cleats Andre gave me would improve my game. Andre wanted to record my form on camera, so he could analyze it. Finally, something I could understand.
The technique right here is pretty decent. So when you get on the field, you have to remember what you've seen right now.
When I got back on the field, I tried to apply what I had learned.
I hit the target. Much better, much better.
After our final workout together, he had some words of advice for me.
Might find somebody down there, make friends with him if you're on the same team. And then, you know, he might need some help in his schoolwork. You can help him in his schoolwork. He can help toughen you up. But more than anything, you're making strides.
Yeah.
You are getting better. But you can't get down on yourself. Right. Let's get better, all right?
Sid, you're in. Let's go. There he is.
Finally, it was my moment to shine. It was now or never.
Hey, good job out there.
Took some shots, which speaks a lot about him. You know, I was proud of him for getting up.
1, 2, 3,
BASS!
We go, baby!
Yeah, really good game tonight, man.
Thanks, Derek.
And he did it.
I think he did a great job. I think he stepped up to the challenge, and I'm proud of him.
He played like a man. He's tough now.
What's up, baby? What's the tears for?
I think I cried maybe 18,000 times, even when I was in the pros. So don't worry about it. There's nothing wrong with crying.
Not always about the fruit at the end of the journey. It's always about what you do to get there. At the beginning of this, I was hopeless, I was scrawny.
Come on, baby.
The definition of nerd was sit. And now I'm definitely not a nerd. I came out here, got hit. I got back up. I wanted to quit many times throughout this whole experience. Now, I'm a driven person. I know that I can succeed in my goals because I don't quit. And I just see a stronger person overall.